Do subscribe to Ikigai channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Human Respiration. In that, we are studying topic respiratory organs in animals. We all know that humans breathe with the help of lungs, trachea, alveoli. But animals like frog, worms, how do they breathe? Today we'll be studying about that. Respiratory system in animals. Now if I talk about man is also an animal, basically a mammal. In us or in human beings, the respiratory system consists of trachea, alveoli, pharynx, larynx, nostrils. But small animals like frogs, leeches, birds, apes, fishes, they cannot afford to have a big respiratory system as we human beings have. Their body systems are very, very small. So they have respiratory system, but it is very tiny and very articulate in nature. The respiratory system does all the function in a precise manner, but in compact fashion. So how does this animals respirate? First, by using body surface respiration. Now when I talk about body surface respiration, protozoans, sponges do direct respiration using their body surface by the principle of diffusion. Yes, you heard me right, diffusion. Movement of lower substance and concentration. Second one, skin. Now cutaneous respiration can be seen in annelids and frog. We all know that frogs are amphibians. They are the animals that can live on land as well as water. So frogs tend to respire with the help of their skin. Isn't it strange, with the help of their skin? Second is, we can talk about tracheal respiration. Now when I talk about tracheal respiration, trachea is something that is present in us as human beings and it is called as windpipe. So tracheal respiration is found in centipedes. Now centipedes are small worms who have golden colored segments on their body, and we all must have seen them in rainy seasons. They have tracheal respiration. So there is some similarity in tracheal respiration of centipedes and human beings. Gills. Now gills are present in fishes. Every fish has gills in it through which it respires, and fishes live in water. Now we all know that inside water, the concentration of oxygen would be very low and carbon dioxide release would be high. As in the outer atmosphere, or you can say in the terrestrial nature, concentration of oxygen is much, much higher as compared to water, which has low concentration of oxygen. Lastly, lungs. Now respiration through lungs is also known as pulmonary respiration. Your snakes, reptiles, lizards all respire through lungs. So snakes do have lungs, not big as we do have, but yes, they do have lungs. Respiratory organ in animals. Now, the respiratory organs in animal or the area which help them to respire could be many. One of them is body surface respiration. When I talk about body surface respiration, the outer surface or the outer skin layer of that particular organism may help them to respire in certain conditions. For example, sponges and protozoans. Now, these protozoans could be Plasmodium or any other protozoan. They do direct respiration. When I say direct respiration, what I'm trying to say is they basically rely on the principle of diffusion. Now, we all know diffusion is nothing but movement of gaseous molecules from higher concentration to lower concentration, and this movement is done by the upper layer of their skin. Second one is the skin or cutaneous respiration. Now, animals like frog and annelids, frogs being amphibians, whenever they are inside water, they do respiration with the help of their skin. We all know that inside water, lungs won't help them to respire. But whenever frogs are outside, that is terrestrial or on the land, they respire with the help of their lungs. So it is always said that during the process of hibernation. Now, hibernation could be said as a process during which animals basically the processes in their cell, their metabolism, anabolism, catabolism would be really very slow or it will be really halted. They eliminate during this process of skin or cutaneous respiration carbon dioxide 2.5 times, that is almost half the number faster than the normal respiration. And in case of frogs, this is basically inside water. Third one, tracheal respiration. Now, tracheal respiration is similar to trachea in we human beings or the windpipe in human beings. When windpipe in human beings contract and relax, we respire. Similarly, in animals or you can say organisms like centipedes, tracheal tube or you can say the longitudinal tube, which is little hollow, and the branched system. Now, this branch system necessarily not be alveoli, bronchioles, not necessary. The other branch systems help the centipedes to respire. Respiration through gills is a propagative or is a parameter through which your fishes basically deal with. And now gills are present on fishes which help in efficiently removing out carbon dioxide or just intaking or oxygen. Removal of carbon dioxide from fish's body and intaking dissolved oxygen from water. Next, whenever water flows through the gills, it is in one direction, that is in one proportional direction, whereas blood flow is always opposite to the direction of water flow through the gills. Now, blood will flow through the blood vessels termed as capillaries, and this counter current help in the maximum exchange of oxygen, that is intake of oxygen and removal out of carbon dioxide. And lastly, respiration through lungs or pulmonary respiration, which takes place in snake. Students, in this part of the chapter, we did study about respiratory organs in animals. I hope we are very clear with this concept. Thank you.